Hi and welcome to the workflow video of the Ableton Live Tools for SPAT Revolution video series. If you haven't seen the first and the second video, I invite you to do so. Please bear in mind that this workflow is not an end-all be-all, and your feedback is of course very welcome. Let's get into the workflow. So I will start by using my macOS shortcut to stop all external connection. It will also start my SPAT Revolution. I will start up live. We will now open the templates for Live and SPAT located in the template folder that we have already set up during the previous video. Once both templates are opened, as you can see in the setup panel of SPAT Revolution, we have the direct output of Live going into a master block and then into the actual output. Everything is parametered to let you do anything inside Live without having to do anything in SPAT. So you can start creating right away. You will note that we have a control device on the master track to actually control the output of Live, and that we have also a group of purple track that will host the room and return device controlling the room and return already present in SPAT. For a more detailed description of all of it, please check the workflow part of the written version of the guide. Note that all the parameters in all the devices can be mapped to a MIDI controller. Or if you have the Ableton push 2, it will be automatically mapped. We are now going to make a quick session to show you how the workflow works. So here, like everyone with an empty session, I'm looking for inspiration. For now, we don't have to pay attention to SPAT. It's just pure creation. I like the sound of this pad, so we are going to start with this. In this video, I will not talk about creation techniques, as this video would easily turn into a 4-hour session. However, if you wish to see that happen, please let us know in the comment section and we might do a live stream about this. So I made a kick loop right here. To note that we still haven't done anything with SPAT yet. I'm gonna quickly increase my block size so we can avoid glitch in the sound. Let's send the kick to SPAT. So first, we are going to create an input block. I'm gonna set this block to a mono one as I want to keep my kick focused on a single direction. Connect the block to the room by drag and dropping the input block to the room one. This will automatically create a source block, which is the actual representation of the kick in the 3D view. Select the input channel we will use for the kick, and then select the same one as the output of the kick track inside Live. Click the room to switch to the 3D view. As you can see, the object is here and is correctly receiving the audio from the kick. We can now place a send device from our SPAT folder. This device will allow us to control the object inside SPAT. You will have many parameters available, and you will have even more parameters if you choose to use the advanced version located in the alternate version folder. If you wish to know everything there is to know about those devices, please check out the corresponding part in the written version of the guide. The link is of course in the description. We are now going to add the pad to SPAT. So again, create a new input block and select the channel you will use for this object. And here, I'm gonna keep the kick and the bass later in a separate room and create a new room for the rest of the objects. I will set this room to binaural and keep the first room for the kick and bass as stereo without any reverb applied to keep the punch of those elements. Connect the block to the room and the room to the output block. I am going to switch the stream type of both the master block as well as the output block. You can go into the plugin located in the send device and open the interface to change the name of the object inside SPAT. In the 3D view, you also have the gain fader that will allow you to mix and balance the level of your objects. We are going to speed up a little bit as here, I am simply trying to create a wider and more interesting harmony of my pad by creating layers, which I also sent to SPAT using the same process. So if we sum up, create a track in Live, create a corresponding input block in SPAT, make sure they are on the same channel or channels in case of a stereo source, connect the block to a room and place a send device on the track in Live. And that's it for creating objects in SPAT. So this is where we are at with my pad texture. Now I'm going to show you how to automate. Please remember that the setup video is really important to make everything as seamless as possible. Let's place the automator device from our SPAT folder on one of the layers of my pad. Again, the description of the device is in the written version of the guide. I will quickly fine-tune my automation to what I want to achieve, and then map the LFO to the parameter I want to automate in the send device. Of course, you can map the LFO before automating it, and then fine-tune. Here, I will automate the azimuth parameter, which will make the source turn around us. I will slow down the automation a little bit, and set the distance to something I like a little bit more. I'm gonna do the same for the two other layers of pads, and change the automation slightly, as well as their distance.
We are now starting to have an interesting layer.
I also played a little with the enable button inside the send device of the second pad. Don't forget to increase your buffer inside Live and SPAT to keep your audio clean of glitches the more you add tracks and objects.
And from there, I think you get the rest, so let's keep a bit ahead.
If you want to see the whole process of making this demo session, a link to a raw, uncut version is in the description.
Quick note here. So far I had two rooms, but only one track that was controlling the first room. And so I am creating a new track in my group to place a new room control device to control the second room, which is the binaural one. And this will allow me to work on the reverb of this room. For a change, I will be using the advanced version of the room device in the alternate version folder. I'm gonna use the randomize button to see if I can get a reverb that inspires me.
Don't worry, the gain parameters are, of course, excluded from the randomizations.
Like any parameter in Live, you can automate everything of each device. For now, my session is an 8-bar loop, and I want to make some automation on the room device, and so I will add a clip and start automating. The automation I made here is just to trigger the infinite mode of the reverb at the last bar of my loop only for the binaural room. This automation will be made using the more traditional way of making automation in Live by drawing an automation line instead of using an LFO like we previously did.
Of course, you can automate the parameters of any device using the automation line instead of an LFO. Let's have a listen to the project.
Of course, don't forget to save your project. I will start by saving my Ableton Live project, then go into the setup page of SPAT and click the Save As button. Go into the folder generated by Live when creating the project, and I will name the SPAT file exactly the same as the Live project.
And that covers the main component of the Ableton Live tools for SPAT Revolution workflow. This project will be available to you, along with a few others that I will let you discover by yourself. The link to those is of course in the description. Again, you can check the written version of the guide for more in-depth information about the multiple parts of this workflow. I hope that all of this has been insightful, and we have two additional videos you can watch. One is about how to render your immersive mix you made with SPAT Revolution, and the second is about how to translate this workflow to a dual computer setup. If you have any feedback or any ideas on how to improve this workflow, please let us know in the comment. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to never miss a new video from us. And I will see you in the next one.